Welcome everyone. My name is Shannon and I'm a sonographer working in general imaging applications at Philips. In this video, we will look at the four main steps for effective use of ElastQ imaging for liver stiffness assessment. Philips EQI is a Shearwave-based technique which provides real-time feedback, confidence in quantification, and speed to advance the use of elastography in clinical practice. Philips has developed two Shearwave techniques, ElastPQ and ElastQ Imaging. ElastPQ has proven valuable in staging liver disease and reducing the need for costly and painful biopsies in some patients. ElastQ Imaging advances Shearwave elastography, providing a technique that is not only non-invasive and easy to use, but also offers clinicians additional confidence in the reliability of measurements. For an effective use of EQI, Philips developed a robust protocol, including patient's preparation, acquisition advice, sampling strategy, and interpretation guidance. This protocol reflects feedback from expert users and worldwide guidelines. The first step is all about the patient's preparation. For start, please make sure that the patient has been fasting for at least 6 hours. Then position the patient so it increases the rib space and provides an optimal window of acquisition. Supine or left lateral oblique DQ position with the right arm in maximal extension is recommended. Once your patient is in an optimal position, you can proceed and enter patient name, select the C51 transducer, and the customized ElastQ preset. This will include abdomen gen preset settings, a 6-second cine loop, and 12 centimeters of depth. Before starting your exam, you always have the option to choose the units of your measurements. Indeed, within setup, you can select meters per second or kilopascals at default on all of your exams. For an optimal acquisition, we like to recommend to start by finding the segment of the liver where you would like to make your measurements. Ensuring good transducer contact with adequate gel will help you. Then position the transducer in the right intercostal space and aligned with the ribs. Image liver segment 7 or 8 and keep the liver capsule parallel to the transducer surface. We recommend to avoid scanning the left side of the liver as cardiac motion leads to inaccurate results. Look for a section of the liver with fewer vessels and little hypoechogenic structures such as the gallbladder or the bile ducts. You can now begin the Shearwave assessment. Select the Elasto control at the bottom of the touch panel. Position the ROI box in the center of the image and 1.5 to 2 centimeters below the liver capsule. Do not place the ROI box on or near a rib shadow or the liver capsule, as it might generate reverberation artifacts. Ask the patient to pause breathing in a relaxed manner rather than taking and holding a deep breath. We recommend a practice phase to show the patient when the liver is stable. You do not want the patient to take a deep breath in or out. Once you are comfortable, wait for a stable image and acquire a cine loop with a minimum of 6-second length. You have already acquired reliable cine loops. The second step is about placing the sampling calibers in the most representative area so you collect robust and reproducible stiffness measurements. Start by reviewing the acquired cine loop to identify frames where the tissue is stable and the color-coded stiffness velocity map is consistent. Measure areas of most representative colors that change the least over time. Avoid measuring over rib shadows or areas near blood vessels. Verify that the calipers are placed in areas with high confidence, green on the confidence map. Take no more than 2 measurements on 1 frame per cine loop acquisition. One last step is required before you can start the interpretation of the results. For a reliable evaluation of liver stiffness, measurements should be acquired from multiple cine loops of the right lobe. For each cine loop, pick a single frame where no more than 2 calipers should be placed. Once at least 5 calipers on 5 different frames have been acquired, refer to the median across the sampling calipers. It eliminates the outliers. You will find the median in the patient report. Refer to the IQR over median as a quality criterion for measurements in KPA. Anything less than 30% provides strong confidence in your sampling measurements. I just showed the effective use of Philips EQI, which offers a non-invasive and easy-to-use Shearwave technique for a confident liver stiffness assessment. Thank you for watching. I hope that you enjoyed this video.